Dear students, in this section we will see problems with GSM security and the four generations of wireless, that is 1G to 4G. GSM security has several shortcomings including session file, weakness in the COM120 algorithm as well as encryption used between only the MH and the BS. So we will discuss this one by one. First weakness or problem is the session file. The first problem is the long life of authentication session. While the mobile station may be requested to re-authenticate at the beginning of each call, but practically this is not done. Okay, this means that the same session key is used for the dates, so that is the one problem in the GSM. Second is the weak encryption algorithm. The GSM is having a weak encryption algorithm. The traffic is encrypted via the A5 algorithm only over the air between the mobile and the base station. The data are decrypted when they arrive at the base station and are sent from the base station to the operator. Okay, so almost all the GSM implementation uses the COM128 algorithm for the A3 and A8 algorithm. So COM128 algorithm is not authenticated algorithm, and it uses the session key KC is generated by COM128. It actually uses the 54 bits only, and 10 0 bits is added to pad the 64 bits. So obviously this reduces the key space, so key is very short, like our short password is having a shortcomings. Okay, next is encryption between only the mobile host and the base station only. And next is limits to the secret key. If an attacker compromises the secret key KI, the entire security scheme is compromised. It is possible to retrieve the KI from a SIM, that is subscriber identity module, and because of the flaw of COM128 algorithm, by sending selected challenge, the COM128 algorithm responds in a way that reveals the information about KI. Okay, so because of this COM128, it reveals the information about the session key and about the authentication key. So that is the one problem. Other problems in the GSM are, first is there is no data integrity algorithm is used. Data could be modified and receive, and the receiver could not detect it. The data is modified but receiver could not detect it. Second is authentication is performed in only one direction, that is from the user to the network. No mechanism exists to identify the network to the user, and also there is no indication to the user that encryption is being used. Okay, and the last topic is four generation of wireless 1G to 4G. So the first generation means the 1G of wireless wide area communication present in the 1970 and 1980, and it is used to, it uses the analog signals to transmit the voice. As we know, the first generation is only carry the voice. Next is second generation, started in 1990, and it is used to use a digital signal for voice as well as data. So GSM and TDMA is the example of this 2G. 2.5 represent the technology improvements in between 2G and 3G. The third generation 3G support the higher data rates, that is from 144 kbps to 2 mbps and beyond, typically a packet switch using CDM. 3G examples are H, then GPRS, we have heard these words, and WCDMA. Okay, and next comes the 4G. Fourth generation will provide much higher data rate with excess of 20 mbps and is expected to be deployed around 2006 to 2009, and it is still unclear what will be in 4G versus 3G. Okay, so this is regarding the fourth generation of wireless. Okay, so here we have finished our unit 5. So thank you so much.